Valencia is teeming with cafes, bars and restaurants, all serving Spain's national gastronomic export, paella. But it's not here where I want to try it, because only a stone's throw up the road is the national park where the rice is grown.
The Albufeira National Park boasts the largest lake in the country and vast wetlands. This was the first area in Spain to cultivate rice. And now most of the country's paella rice is grown here, in acres of paddy fields. At New Raco, Chef Raúl Meyer prepares authentic Valencian paella at the restaurant's outdoor stove. This dish is traditionally cooked over a wood-burning fire. Valencian paella is the original recipe and is very different to the seafood variations you get in other parts of Spain. The base of the dish is chicken, rabbit and runner beans. The deep colour comes from paprika rather than saffron, which is considered to be a luxury ingredient. Snails are abundant in the surrounding rice fields and are a key ingredient. Raúl uses bomba rice, which is known as the king of paella rice. This is because it absorbs three times its volume in stock without spoiling. Finally, he adds fresh rosemary, which they grow on site, and it's all left to simmer for 20 minutes or until the rice is just cooked. Now I can't wait to try it.
Oh, thank you. Proper, authentic Valencian paella. For one, it doesn't get any better than this. Now, purists will tell you that paella shouldn't contain both meat and fish. But whatever you like to do, have a go at it, because it really is worth the wait. Traditionally, they would have this for Sunday lunch. And to me, it's as good as my roast beef and Yorkshire pudding. That is delicious.
For my next recipe, I'm borrowing the restaurant's indoor kitchen. I'm using ingredients that Valencia's really famous for, including the bomba rice.
Now, this stuff grows all the way from Valencia to Alicante. Bomba is the most traditional rice and the most sought after. That's the creme de la creme of the rice. And it's what I'm going to do to create this dish, or rather incorporate all three of, I think, Spain's most popular foods, oranges, pork and the rice.
Paella is a real labour of love, requiring time and patience. So I'm making a quick and easy pilaf, which still has bags of flavour. First, sweat a diced onion in olive oil before adding rosemary, bay leaves and the rice. Add a touch of white wine and just enough water to cover. Cover with tin foil and leave to gently simmer for 15 minutes.
So while that's cooking, I can get my pork on. This stuff is really special, Iberico pork or pata negra, and it comes from the black-footed pig. And the reason why this is so special is that it's bred on acorn.
The acorn diet results in the meat being marbled with fat, which keeps even a lean cut like a fillet nice and tender.
So I'm going to cook this with some sea salt and pop the pork straight into our paella pan. I'm just going to seal that nicely. Now the meat is much darker than our conventional pork, and that's because of the way it's produced simply. It really is, to me, the king of all pork and all hams. There's nothing better than pata negra. So I'm looking forward to how this is going to taste. A little bit of colour on there. I've set the oven about 180, and this wants to cook now, not for long, for about 6 to 8 minutes.
With my pork fillet in the oven, it's time to crack on with the garnish to go with it.
Now, like the rice, Valencian oranges are highly prized, mainly because of their size and their beautiful sweetness. And I'm actually going to use these to create a nice little piquant sauce to go with a selection of veg. But first, I want to segment my orange. Now, the easiest way to do this is start off with a large orange, first of all, but these Valencian oranges are superb. What I do is just carefully go around the outer edge and follow the last slice that you made. That way, you'll continue the shape of the orange and not waste any. We can then quickly segment them. Now, oranges and pork are a classic combination, but what I'm going to do is create a nice little sauce to go with this, with the veg, and almost pickle them in a tiny bit of vinegar. So I've got some carrots here. Cut these up in strips.
Next, I slice some leek, green pepper, onion, celery, and garlic.
Now, these are a few wild mushrooms that I've found, but you can just use the simple brown cap, small little button mushrooms. Will be equally as good, just cut into quarters.
With all the veg prepared, the pork fillet is ready to come out the oven.
There you have it, a lovely roast fillet of our Berico pork. But what it does need now is to rest. Very, very important, especially with the Berico pork, because of all the work that it does in the field, the meat is much tighter, so we need it to relax a little bit. In the meantime, we can make our sauce. Hot pan, sugar. This is just caster sugar. We want about 4 tablespoons. Crank up the heat. We want this to caramelise now and get this lovely brown, nutty colour. And it's very important at this stage that you get that right texture to your caramel. If it's not caramelised, you're not going to end up with that sort of almost bitterness to the sauce, which goes really well with the pork. You can see in the pan now, it's starting to caramelise quite quickly. And at this point, I'm then going to get ready on our oranges. And our most important ingredient for this, vinegar. This is sherry vinegar. We need to deglaze the pan with the vinegar. Now, at the same time, we're going to add some chicken stock. Keep mixing it on the high heat. You see already, look at the colour that you get from that caramel. I'm going to add some orange juice. And then just to help the vinegar and to counteract too much sweetness, some lemon.
Once the sauce has come back to the boil, all the veg goes in minus the orange segment, which gets added right at the very end. The veg needs just a couple of minutes to soften, so it's time to check on the rice.
So you've got the rosemary, the bay. This rice is fantastic. Just going to finish off now our sauce with the orange segments. Little stir around together. And all the time, the sauce is reducing and get this lovely shine on the top. That's what we're looking for. It's very nice. And then I can then take our lovely piece of pork. It's delicious. And then just simply, just spoon your vegetables over the top. Pickled and sweet. Some of that delicious sauce over the top. And then finally, what I love, just a few celery leaves over the top. And there you have it, my little homage to the fabulous place, Valencia.